Hey guys, Pete from Pete2Cents.com, January 10, 2012. I'm showing you guys here a Dow chart, 6 months, going from October 2011 into today. And we're showing that we've retested a couple times after the 2009 crash. And finally, we're above the 200-day line and the 50-day line. And we've been rallying up quite a bit. You know, again, you know, pullbacks and so forth, but I think they're healthy pullbacks. And if you average down, you've done fine. My concern is if we're heading into a V or W recession, which many people call the double dip. And I got a little bit of concern. I'm very bullish on the overall market, but my concern goes into effect probably into 2012, into 2013 as well. So we're going to get some resistance at 12.6, 12.7, and then 14,000 is going to be the real test. And I'll show you that on the next chart. You'll see here on this particular chart, you'll see that I pulled it out quite a bit into the 5-year time frame, and you got to look at the overall, you know, the macro view to get a good sense of what the market's going to do on a day-to-day, believe it or not, or even on a month-to-month, and obviously quarter-to-quarter, and then year-to-year. You can't have such a tight look on it, because then you can't really see where the market or where a stock, a particular stock or a group of stocks are going. But you'll see here on a 5-year chart that we got a lot of resistance points after a major recovery. And again, the 2009 crash. So here you'll see, and I'm going to show you that on the next chart, that we have a steep, steep decline and then a massive recovery. And of course, you know, there's many, many reasons for that, but this is where my concern comes in. The V recovery is exactly that, what it sounds like. It looks like a V, okay? And, you know, you'll see that this is, again, the same chart. It's a 5-year chart, and we pulled it out, and I just drew a large V there, so you see what I'm talking about. And, of course, we didn't end in the V. We pulled back right where the V had to retest, just slightly, and then we're doing well on a recovery. But if you see, once we start approaching, what is that, almost 14,000, we're going to get some resistance at 12.6, like I told you before, 12.7. Then we're going into 13,000, and my problem, the biggest problem that I have is that the recovery is too steep. You understand? It's like the old saying, what goes up must come down. And I like recoveries that are more slanted, you know what I mean? More diagonal. Not that steep decline, okay, falling off a cliff, and then a steep recovery. I rather see it more diagonal, slow and steady, okay? And a W recovery, you'll see now. On this particular chart, you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. A W recovery that's not a full W, okay? We're talking about the same V, of course. I'm not the best artist out there as far as drawing, but you'll see it's the same V. This is the same 5-year chart, and you got your resistance and your recovery points. And you'll see the V that is, you know, is what I showed you before. And then we're starting to pull back, okay? So what's left is a recovery, and which the recovery has to, well, I'm sorry, is the double dip before a full recovery. And this is where you get the second half of the W. So that's where my concern is. I mean, once we start hitting 13, 14,000, it doesn't have to be exactly 13 or 14,000, but that's where you're going to get major resistance. Okay, so that's my concern. What to do? There's a few things you can do. As I said, I maintain to be bullish, but I would definitely be very cautious. And with that said, I would definitely try to put your stop orders no more than 10 to 12%, even though there's a lot of people that talk between 8 and 10, but I think 10 to 12%, any stock that you know, is pulling back to 10%, usually I'm buying at 10%. But, you know, we would have to, you know, relook at the and reevaluate at the overall market. So in other words, if at 10% you see that the market is really tanking overall, not your particular stock, overall, then I would say, you know, it's time to bail out and stay in cash. If the market's doing well, then I would say buy at 10%. Okay, guys? Pete from Pete's2Cents.com, and I'll talk to you guys in the next video.